met him, be glad in him. We'll be ready going to the Word of the Lord today. We're in the book of Psalms. And I actually went off today and left my case, my laptop, my everything. I'm glad I'm safe. I'm glad I'm safe, but I went off and I actually stacked everything together. And began to put other things into the car, and I left that there at the house. But nevertheless, put the word then stay at the house.
Amen.
We still got mail.
Amen. All right.
Point to yourself and say, you got mail.
You got mail.
Supernatural mail.
Amen.
Supernatural. I'm just ready for some mail.
Amen.
Bring it.
Amen. Mail from the Lord. Amen. I'm just excited today. Amen. And let's go to Psalms, the 100. Psalms 1. But I woke up this morning hearing God talk about, or hear him saying, talking about being in the place of God. Being in the place of God. Knowing where you are is just as important as knowing who you are.
Hello.
Yeah.
Hello.
Place of God is everything. Being in the place of God is everything. Things happen when you're in the right place. When you're in the right place, things happen. In the prophet, things happen when you're in the right place. Amen. You get rewarded when you're in the right place. On the football field, it pleases the team. Am I right? Amen. You can fulfill your assignment when you're in the right place, Justin. Can't be all over the place.
Yeah.
There's a place that you are supposed to flow, flourish, increase. Every area of your life, be it spiritually, physically, mentally, and financially.
Yeah.
It's a place called there. Preached that word many, many years ago, driven to a place called there. And the place of there has expiration dates that you can move on. Mm-hmm. 1 minute it may be there. Mm-hmm. Then when that season up, God got something else for you. But it's important to be in that place at the right time that you can get all that God has for you. Mm-hmm. How many is hearing that?
Yeah.
Amen. Let's go to Psalms 1 and starting with verse 1. It says, blessed is the man that walketh not in the counsel of the ungodly, nor standeth in the way of sinners, nor sitteth in the seat of the scornful. Blessed, but his delight is in the law of the Lord, and his law doeth he meditate day and night. That's the conversation prophet's talking about. The conversation of God, you meditate day and night. All right? Okay. And he shall be like a tree planted by the rivers of water that bringeth forth fruit in his season. His leaf also shall not wither. And whatsoever he doeth shall prosper. Now we're going to identify those that prosper.
Mm-hmm. Amen. Amen.
Okay.
Let's go back. We're going to see, can we catch those that prosper? What's the ingredients to those that prosper? Israel came out of Egypt, but never really fully went into what God wanted them to have. How I mean, you can come out of a thing geographically and never go into a thing spiritually and mix and miss the place that God was trying to, even though you say, I'm not there no more, but you're not there either.
Yeah.
You're still not there.
Yeah.
You know, you left, but you have not arrived either.
Yeah.
So now transition has become your enemy. Now the transport from A to B, watch this here. Let's use a natural airplane. Say you're trying to get to California from Dallas. And actually, the airplane is intended to be a blessing to you.
Come on now.
But now, a two-hour trip, and you still ain't arrived in California.
Come on now.
Now you reported missing. You follow what I'm saying? So now you just wondering. You left, but you ain't arrived.
Come on now.
So it's just like you haven't left, because you still ain't arrived.
Yeah.
It's one thing to geographically leave something and another thing to enter something spiritually. It has to be a mental move.
Yes.
An inward
move. That's the key.
Your body can get up and do something, but your heart got to be in it. It's many things. You can leave something because you was in fear. And you can leave because it's time to leave.
Amen.
It makes a big difference. You follow what I'm saying? It's different in the spirit.
It is.
Blessed is the man that walketh not in the counsel of the ungodly, or standeth in the way of sinners, nor sitteth in the seat of scornful, but his delight is in the law of the Lord, and in his law doeth he meditate day and night. And he shall be like a tree planted. Someone say planted.
Planted.
Planted by the rivers of water that bringeth forth fruit in his season. And his leaves shall also, his leaf also shall not wither, and whatsoever he doeth shall prosper. Now here's the thing about it is that Israel came out of Israel, or out of Egypt, and a short trip took 40 years. And the word of God in the book of Deuteronomy is 9, the book of Deuteronomy 10, it talks about for every day that they doubted God, because they doubted him for 40 years. I mean, for 40 days they had doubt, and he gave them a year. For every day they doubt, he added a year to their doubt. Three days journey out. And took them 40 years to get nowhere. And then God, that was the first group, and then God had to raise up the second group. Because the first group missed it. Because they begin to wonder. What would cause somebody to wonder in a place 40 years? They begin to wonder. They begin to wonder. When you let your mind wonder, he didn't say wonder, he said meditate upon my word. He didn't say wonder. You have wondering mind. I ain't gonna be before you long. You got wondering mind. You ever see people come? You can come into a place of God and have a wondering mind.
Yeah.
Deliverance is right there, but you got a wondering mind, and you can't wrap your word, your mind around the faith of God because the mind is wondering what it's gonna do next. Is anybody hearing me?
Yeah.
Yes, sir.
Right in the presence of God to get everything you need, but you got your mind on worry. Stood in
now.
Faith, it comes in and it, see, you got that mind is something else.
Mm-hmm.
It'll distract you.
Yes.
It'll have you concerned about stuff that don't even matter.
Hello.
I know, been there, done that, got the captain t-shirt.
Mm-hmm.
that don't have nothing to do with nothing. And when you get through with that distraction, you still got to come back to focus.
Come on now.
Because ain't nothing in distraction but worry.
Yeah.
Ain't nothing in the spirit of distraction but worry. See, either you're going to meditate upon the word of God, or you're going to be distracted by another thought.
Mm-hmm.
And you know something? Distraction, the spirit of distraction, Brother Tipper, don't discriminate. You know how young you are, how old you are. You can be young.
Yeah.
It'll put you to sleep. Yeah. It'll make you start thinking about sports when God's trying to give you a word beyond sports.
Yeah.
It'll get you all kind of crazy thoughts. Have you looking at stuff you shouldn't be focused on?
Yeah.
Israel and them began to be governed by what they saw with their natural eye. They began to be governed by that. What they seen, their eyes took over what God was saying. Mm-hmm. See, the word of God said you walk by faith and not by sight.
Come on now. Mm-hmm.
Because your natural eye puts you in touch with your feelings. Mm-hmm. Then you start feeling everything. Then if it don't feel right, you don't do it. Now that is a bad feeling, there's a good feeling. But I'm talking about that feeling that always comes to when you get ready to step ahead, you step back. Mm-hmm. You second guess yourself. Have you ever been in that second guess mode?
Oh yeah. Mm-hmm.
You was in faith for a season, then second guess mode.
Yeah.
You start trying to add it all up. Mm-hmm. You can't add the supernatural up.
Okay. Come on now.
You can act the supernatural. If you really trust me, if you're in here now, you hear me by YouTube, and you really believe in God for something, you can't start spirit then go natural.
Come on now. Mm.
You can't pray spiritual, then come out of prayer and go natural.
Come on now.
You prayed spiritual about it, but when Monday hit or Sunday or the same day or the next 5 minutes, you went natural. You start trying to calculate it up. Mm.
No.
Well, if so-and-so don't let me in, then it won't happen. Mm. Well, the last report I got, the doctor said, oh, watch this here, you in faith in a commercial car. And remind you, if you don't get that check, what could happen? See, you see how thoughts? Mm.
Yeah.
Thoughts would delay you? Mm. Thoughts would throw you out the rhythm of faith?
Yes.
I went to get my eyes checked the other day. Lady said, do you want to check for so-and-so and so-and-so? I said, no. I said, do a normal check.
Yeah.
Do you have insurance? And I'm being honest, I have insurance. I said no. And I do. But I pay for it because I know how it goes. Once I got insurance, then you want to further dig.
Yeah.
So why wasn't it important anymore when I tell you I didn't have no insurance?
See,
it didn't come back up no more. Mm-hmm. I had insurance, but I'm not going to pay you for what I already know.
Yeah.
As a matter of fact, I know about five. See, I know, but okay. He said, "Can you see?" I said, "I came in here, didn't I?" And I read in the chart that you said, and then I told her, she said, "Can you see?" I said, "I came in here, didn't I?" Did I come in here? I mean, I didn't get the question. I mean, I'm on the slow bus or something, but I didn't get the question. But what I'm saying is, I couldn't let her rattle my faith.
Yeah, that's right.
Mm-hmm. See, I know where I'm at. I know what I'm doing. Huh. I'm not going to be moved. Mm-hmm. I mean, once you done heard, you done heard it. Why do you need to keep hearing it?
Come on now.
I'm still living. I see you. I'm good. And I can see in the spirit.
Say.
And I know her spirit. So we didn't proceed and we did something different. See, you can't get sold out on other folks' lust.
You can't.
Hello.
Mm. Y'all, somebody y'all missed
no,
that.
Yeah. Okay.
You spend an arm and a leg if you don't get in the spirit on stuff. Ooh, you know, it's cheap to live the life of a spirit than live in your flesh. It's expensive to be in the flesh, man. You get took every time.
Hello.
And then you end up paying for your own mistakes.
Yeah.
When you could just slow down and hear God. Because if God said it, he's going to bag it up.
Yeah.
If you ever can get a yes out of God, I don't care from wind, storm, hail, when all they get through blowing, yes, it's going to be right there.
Say.
May I help you?
Yeah.
Say.
When you get through boo-hooing and, oh, Lord, oh, Jesus, I don't know what I'm going to do. He's going to say, man, you could have saved them tears.
Say.
I have a reputation of being faithful.
Yeah.
Say. Nothing I see. Ask the star to step on nothing but my word. Ask the sun to stand on nothing but my word.
Yeah.
Ask the wind what it stands on. Mm-hmm.
Come on now.
Ask oxygen. You ever seen oxygen?
No.
You ever seen wind?
No.
Mm-hmm. You follow what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. You got some of y'all in an airplane, you still don't know how they function.
Hello.
A big piece of metal hanging up in the air.
Yeah.
Comes with nothing under. That's God stuff, man.
Yes, it is.
How many of you don't give knowledge to make plain? Man ain't did that. Man ain't that God. Pick up my phone and I'm in Germany just like that.
Yeah.
On my telephone. The distance between earth and heaven is faith.
Yeah.
Hello.
You get that tomorrow. You get that tomorrow.
That's a mind blow.
You get that tomorrow. Tweet, tweet. Don't you say you said it. Tweet, tweet. I need somebody. Tweet, tweet. The distance. Are you hearing me, young prophets?
Yeah.
Come give me five. My little prophet like that. Come and give me five. He liked it. He smiled at me when I said that. He called a revelation. You ain't got to beg. You just got to know the distance of where your supply is. The distance to your supply. The distance to everything you need is faith. Between earth and faith. Come on here. Come on. That's your spiritual cell phone. If you ever can make it to your spiritual cell phone. You ain't heard nothing I said. You following me?
Yeah.
You following me, Tiffany?
Yeah.
I want you to hear me. I want you to really hear that. Just contact your faith. Now, don't worry about all that. Just get off into your faith and let your faith get off into you.
Yeah.
Hello.
You ain't hear nothing I said. Get off into your God-given faith, mother, and let your faith get off into you. I know how thoughts come. I know how thoughts. I know what they'll tell you. I know how suicide spirits and thoughts will come. I'm going to kill you. I'm going to take you out. I've had them thoughts. They done came to me.
Hello.
Yeah.
Okay. They real.
Jesus, thank you, Lord.
I'm bound. I'm bound.
Hello.
I'm bound.
Yes, Lord.
Touch me, God, will raise me right back up.
Hello.
You follow what I'm saying? Are you in this? Anybody in this?
Yes.
Faith is the spiritual currency.
Yes.
Yeah.
It don't cost nothing to believe, just believe. You can't be ifing around God.
Hello.
Don't be up there ifing around God.
Come on now.
Be the in faith. Ifing. The English definition of if is doubt. Check it out. If is not a beautiful word. When somebody gets the ifing, doubt. Your English word chase gift. If down, if comes out to be nothing but doubt. End of the day, it's doubt. If. Conditional. If. Come on. If is not an if without an I.
Come on now.
If I don't care till there ain't no if.
Hello.
Say.
If need an I to participate, to be a word. A if need an I.
Yeah.
Don't you be the I to the if.
Come on now.
You don't hear nothing I say.
Yeah.
Did you catch that, students?
Yes, sir.
You tell doubt, you tell if, I will not be your I. So then that means you won't exist in my life.
Yeah, that's right.
If I don't allow you to be a word in my thought,
come
you
on
don't
now.
Even exist.
Come on now.
See, that's good.
If can't even be used in a sentence. It won't even make sense. If you move away.
Yes, sir.
You get that somebody never leave that. Did you catch that, young man?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. It's an equal opportunity.
Yes, it is.
You follow me. Don't dig nowhere. Just stay right where I'm at. Don't you go nowhere else with that. Just circle that right there. Circle that. Just circle that right there. That's what I say. If thy kin believe. If. In other words, if you don't doubt, it'll happen. That's all it's saying. If you don't doubt, it'll happen. If you don't doubt it, it's possible. That's all he said when he said, if thy kin. If you don't doubt it, it's possible.
Okay.
Keep moving. Right into what God say.
Hallelujah.
You keep moving right into what God say.
Glory.
You keep moving right into what God say.
Yes, sir.
Because wherever God is sending you, he's already been.
Say,
he's already checking out for you guys.
Say.
He's your personal, is it, CIA?
Yeah.
He went before you as an agent, Holy Spirit.
Hallelujah.
and check your assignment out. Close is clear. Close is clear.
Come on.
It's clear now.
Amen.
You can move in now.
Yes, sir. Thank you, Lord.
God will never send you anywhere where he becomes unnecessary. You got to be willing to move on. Spider the way it look, didn't tell you to count nothing. Didn't tell you to add nothing up. Because the miracles are in the steps. Steps of a good man are ordered. I'm just hearing that. You think you got a problem, and God will let you meet somebody with a problem. And you become a solution to their problem. And when you free them, you free thyself.
Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah.
Are you following what I'm saying?
Jesus.
Are you hearing what I'm saying, Sister Mama? You sitting there with problems at your feet. But also you got promises on your shoulders. So why you would just let problems at your feet trouble you when there is promises sitting on your shoulder? That's the authority of God. That's the government of God. You got promises. Rest. And you keep focused on the little problems around that surround your feet.
Yes.
And he said, the steps of a good man are ordered by the Lord, and I'm going to walk into that that's resting on your shoulder.
Yes.
Hallelujah today.
Are you following what I'm saying? Don't even give them attention. They're just problems that you're going to solve.
Hallelujah.
Don't you know God can sustain you many ways?
Yes.
God can take anything in creation and sustain you.
Yeah.
You hear nothing I say.
Amen.
As Elijah in 1 Kings 17.
Come on here.
Awesome.
Come on here.
Jesus.
He finally got to a human being, but the first, he sustained the prophet by a stinky raven.
Come on now.
Something that divine. Dead stuff and water from a brook that wasn't purified.
Come on now.
But when God got in it, God took something natural and did something supernatural with something natural.
Come on now.
Are you following what I'm saying, Mom?
Yes, sir.
He let him prophesy something and let him live under the prophecy that he prophesied.
Yeah.
There shall not be dew nor rain, but according to my words. And he lived under that same prophecy.
Yeah.
And was sustained. Until God dried the brook up. I said, not the devil, God dried the brook.
Come on now.
Because sometimes we're quick to call stuff the devil to be God.
Yeah.
God will dry some stuff up too.
Yes,
come on now.
I'm the devil. That's the enemy. My supervisor don't like me. My so-and-so don't like me. So-and-so don't like me. It ain't about none of that. God growing you up.
Yes,
he is.
God moved me from there to here. From here to there.
Yeah.
He got you in rotation. He got you in circulation. Because he's about to facilitate.
Yeah.
About to get something, trying to get something to you. How many see anyone? How many could use something to come to you right now?
Yeah.
Amen. How many could use the right person coming to you right now?
Yes.
Because all the time it may not show up.
Yeah.
In money, it may show up in a person.
Yeah.
It may show up in a relationship.
Yeah.
So, can I submit to you? You know, sometimes, some places, your money ain't no good.
Yeah.
But a relationship is?
Yeah.
You may have the money and still can't get in.
Still.
Because your name ain't among the ain't among the list. But by relationship. Are we hearing this? Someone say planted. I must be planted in the place of God. Planted and present. In his presence. You must be planted. You know, the word of God says, say, be fruitful and multiply. But I never seen fruit grow that wondered.
Come on now.
See, if you're going to be fruitful and multiply, that means that something has to be planted.
Yeah.
Fruit don't grow where they're not planted. Ain't no fruit going to grow on a moving tree.
Say.
Come on now. Your tree, one day you wake up, your tree is in your yard, the next day it's in Tiffany's yard.
Yeah.
But planted. You got to be planted. You got to be planted in the place of God, and in the place of God is where you flow. It's where you flow, where you flourish, where you increase.
Yes.
In the place of God. And then in the place of God, you find out the what's and the why's.
Amen.
In the place of God.
Yeah.
You see, it's in the place of God where no weapon formed against you shall prosper. Come in the down. Place of God.
Mm-hmm. Amen. Yeah.
Peace come, mother, in the place of God. Mm-hmm. Healing comes in the place of God. Mm-hmm. The assignment is given in the place of God.
Amen.
If there's an assignment, it's a place the assignment goes down. And if it's an assignment, your assignment is attached to a people.
Yeah.
It's going to be attached. It ain't nothing. If you got really something from God, it's going to connect us to somebody.
Yeah.
Ain't no self-made nobody.
Come on,
Jeff. You give us some people, she was a self-made millionaire. Mm-hmm. That's crap.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Come on now.
God didn't make nobody.
That's right.
To be self-sufficient.
Correct.
That ain't even that don't even fly with the universe. You self-made millionaire. No. All the millionaires and billionaires need to thank anybody that helped them get there.
Yeah.
Because you did not get there alone.
Yeah.
My daddy left there. Who left it for him?
Mm-hmm.
Some kind of service got it in.
Yeah.
Come on.
Ain't no self-made nothing. Sufficiency is of the Lord. Yeah. Y'all hear what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Yes, sir.
If you got a dream, it's going to take a team to fulfill it.
Hallelujah.
Right.
Somebody got to help facilitate that.
Yeah.
Come on. It's going to be more than just you.
Come on.
Somebody's putting it together. Are you hearing me, sister?
Yes, sir.
Yeah.
You hear me? Well, mother got a lot of stuff. Mother writing over there. Mother going on a second. Y'all lacking. Mother on a second. Mother came back. I don't know where she went, but she came back. But she did. She got on the second page.
Yeah.
Mother, whatever it is, I'm gonna get this. Are y'all hearing this here?
Yes.
And you shall be like a tree planted by the rivers of water. Rivers of water, that's word, that's spirit, that's life, that's revelation. In the place of God is where God speak to you. You can't force God to speak to you when you're not in the place.
All right.
You can't bend his arm to make him speak to you. See, it's time to be detailed with God.
Yes,
I think I'll just sit here.
Jesus.
I think I'll just sit here. And the Spirit of God is urging you to come right here. Well, I'm in the room, but it's something about right here. You ever start to sit somewhere, but you then you, I don't know. That wasn't about you. Spirit. You actually wanted to sit the first seat you got to. Spirit said, no, this is. See, detail.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Detail. Detail.
Yeah.
God's a detail. He'll tell you left, he'll tell you right.
Yeah.
He'll tell you stop, he'll tell you go. He'll tell you don't wear that, where it is, take that off.
Hello. Mm-hmm.
You ever got ready to go to God and say, take all that off?
Yeah.
It's a distraction to me. Take that off. Get out of all that.
Yep.
Amen.
Yeah.
See, it's important to be what God wants you to be.
Yes.
It's important to be in the place called there. Mm-hmm. Provision is in the place called there.
Come on, prophet. That's
I said provision is in the place. God bless you, mighty woman of God.
You come down the highway.
That's how you work. You're in Beverly Hills. Yeah, prophet. Grace coming. Beverly Hills, you hear me? As soon as you walked in, you hear me.
Yeah.
Coming down the bed, you can see him.
We know.
What I'm talking about?
We know. You got it.
God sent the SWAT team up in here.
Yeah.
But driven to the place called there.
Yes, sir. Yes, Lord, today.
My family.
Yes,
we are.
You got to know who you are in God.
Yes, you do.
You got to find. You got to know who you are in God. I'm going somewhere. I'm talking,
come on,
I'm talking about you.
You in the house.
As it relates to God.
Yeah. You in the house.
So I'm saying we're His agents.
We're His agents.
Huh? Yeah.
God trying to get us off the need list.
Yeah.
Do you know, he said in the word of God, he said we were priests and kings under God.
Yes.
He said, you are royal, you're a priesthood.
Yeah.
How many know that God wants you to live a regal life?
Yes.
You ain't heard nothing I see. He wants you to live a regal life. What's a regal life? That that's fitting unto a king.
Yeah.
That's a regal life. You too regal to be broke. You too regal to drive that. You too regal to live like that. You too regal to talk like that. You too regal. Because you gotta say those things that's fitting unto you. That's
what
you got. Somebody cut. No, I'm too regal, baby. I'm too regal. I'm too regal. I'm too regal. I'm too regal. Come on here. That's the word. Come on here. He said, you're priests and kings under me.
Yeah.
Here's a, I charge God. Tell him I will, God. He said, I'm charging you to live a regal life.
Oh.
From this day forward.
Yes.
I'm charging you to be the priest and king of the God that I made you. I'm charging you to think like me.
Yeah.
I'm charging you to act like me.
Yeah.
I'm charging you to step out.
Come on.
Trust me when you can't even trace me. I'm begging you to come.
Yes.
I'm begging you to come out.
Yes.
I'm begging you to come out of here.
Yes.
I'm begging you.
Yes. Regal life.
To
yes.
shift from poverty to the regal person that
yes.
I made you. So I made you to the image of how you gonna not be regal made into the image of God?
Yes.
I mean, just define that.
Yes.
Where did you fall from to act like you a heathen? Come on, Galilee.
Yes.
Who have bewitched you?
You.
Adam, that woman you gave me. Who told you that?
Yeah.
What did you get that from? Who told you you were sick? Who told you you were broke? Who told you had to put up with that? Who told you?
And why did you believe it?
And why did you?
You can have whatever you say because you read.
Come on,
word of God in your mouth.
Yes,
you got brother. Eternal
yes,
life in your mind. Stuff happens when you say
it. Pastor, yes.
You can accelerate it or you can slow it down.
Yes.
Jesus.
Wait a minute. What are we going to do with it? What are we going to do with 1 Kings 17?
All right. 1 Kings 17.
Elijah prophesied and told the country it won't be dew nor rain.
Yeah.
But
yeah.
according to my word,
who told you,
Elijah, that you could shut up the heaven 3 years?
Yeah.
Go praying, prosper. You ain't the only one, God, up,
you
but God
honored
his word. For 3 years, it didn't rain.
Yeah.
He said it won't be dew nor rain. Many prophets can come, but they won't be able to unlock this.
Yeah.
It was many prophets could unlock the heaven.
Yes.
Elijah, and watch this here. He wasn't even filled with the Holy Ghost.
Oh.
And you filled with he locking up stuff. And when you got God in you, Christ in you, the hope of glory. And you worry about a water bill. Here's the man locking it up. You worry about a job, a man, a husband, a house, a car. And you got a man locking up hell.
Locking up hell.
You worry about how you going to make it.
Jesus.
You're gonna be.
Yes.
Here's a man locking up heaven.
Yes, you can lock up that.
Man.
Thank you,
Lord.
And the earth.
Thank you, Lord.
And you can unlock it.
Yes.
Don't blame no more.
But I take water, what take water though?
Shopping center. Come on, that's your head. Thank you. Yeah, brain to work.
Distance? What I said? The distance between earth and heaven is faith.
Yeah.
Is your faith.
Distance.
Peace.
Today
is so.
Yes.
See, when you know your God, you know your faith.
Amen. You know your God, you know your faith.
Thank you.
That's right. Ooh, that's so good right there. Tweet that, y'all.
Come on.
Tweet that.
Tweet that.
Tweet that out there.
Are you following?
Yes.
And it works for kids.
You know your God, you know your faith.
Faith that works for kids.
Yes,
it does. The only thing please God is faith.
Yeah.
Are you in this?
Thank you.
Go to 1 Kings 17.
Thank you.
Teacher Christ. Teacher.
Lock some things up.
Speak, Lord.
I hear you.
Yeah.
Come on there. You gotta believe that.
Yeah.
You got the power. Speak up in the heavens. Days of old, they talk to the universe. Come on, Joshua.
Yeah.
Joshua was whooping some behind and the sun was going down. And he needed a little more light on the situation.
Yeah.
He said, sign this beast.
God.
That's why you got to leap here.
Yeah.
That's it.
Because Joshua stole a day out of time.
Yeah, that's
bad. He said, Lord, I know it's getting dark, but I got some, the enemy is still coming.
Yeah.
I need you to give me some light on this situation.
Yeah.
I need some more light on the situation.
Yeah.
Spiritually, physically, mentally. I need you to shine some light of faith.
Shine, yeah,
while
faith.
I whoop this thing.
Yeah.
While
yeah.
I can help this
yeah.
Hey.
Yeah.
This uncircumcised
yeah.
Philistine.
Jesus.
This demon.
Yes. Jesus.
Bad on me. Out for me.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Teacher, prophet, teacher. Speak the ear organ on your body right now.
Yes.
I command you to live.
I command
you to have the same amount of life as my spirit.
Amen.
Not a look. I ain't going nowhere. Ear organ in your body, spiritually, physically, mentally, financially, everything in your body.
In the name of Jesus.
Just like your natural body got five senses, mm-hmm. your spirit do too.
Yeah.
Hello.
Your spirit can hear, it can see, it can talk.
Ooh. Yes, it can.
I know what I'm talking about.
Speak.
I just came out of my body before.
Yes, Lord.
And seen me.
Yeah.
Yes,
laying
Lord.
On the bed.
Yes, Lord. Jesus.
And realized I was at my body.
Yeah.
But I still could hear.
Yes.
I still could hear.
And see. Mm-hmm. Teacher, Bryce. Mm-hmm. Teacher. Teacher.
Came home from work one day back when I was in my 20s, and I was sick and laid on the bed, and I seen my body, my spirit come out my body and see me stretched in the bed like I was in the same clothing and everything. I could see my whole house. I could see everything. I could hear. Your spirit can hear you, conscious of everything.
Yeah.
I can see outside. They, nobody can see me, but I can see everybody.
Yeah.
Yes. Jesus, I ain't making this up.
Yeah, I know you.
I seen that. I was aware.
Yeah, you was
yes.
aware.
Yes. I was alert to what was going on. I was in between two worlds.
Ah.
Yes. I knew what was happening spiritually and what was happening naturally.
Mm.
Then when I know anything, I came back into my body.
Yeah.
I wasn't dreaming. This happened.
Yeah, that was real. That's a bad God.
That's why I knew how the spirit can dominate the body.
Yeah, it does. I got to write that down.
Even some attack your body. Demand your spirit to take over.
Yes!
Demand it to take over.
Yeah.
Don't let your spirit, don't allow yourself to fear. Don't allow yourself to fear. Don't house any word that God ain't speaking.
Amen.
Any word that God ain't speaking, don't you house it.
Yes.
Don't you avoid it. Cast it down. Casting down imagination and every high thing. that exalt itself against the knowledge of God, bringing to captive every thought to the obedience of Christ.
Yes, thank you, Lord.
Don't anybody speak nothing on you?
Yeah,
that's right.
Mm-hmm.
It's the season. If it ain't light, don't even receive it.
Ha!
If it ain't light, don't even receive it.
Yeah, that's right.
Don't even
that's right.
See, somewhere they say you got to trust God.
Yeah.
I mean, honestly, but you got to trust God somewhere.
Yeah.
If you say you believe Him, you better kick it in and start believing.
Yeah.
You better really kick it in and start believing.
Yeah, you do. Yeah.
See, and then let me hit this arena too. I'm gonna hit this and back off of it, and then we're gonna go back to Elijah, 1 Kings 17. But let me tell you something. It's a thing called biblical economics.
See.
And you gotta get into biblical economics.
See.
What's that? That's God's way of doing things.
Yeah.
God's way of doing things. Economical.
That's what. And there's but one way you come out of debt. And that's the same way you got in.
That's it.
You have faith to get in it. Now have faith to come out of it.
That's right, Prophet. Right. That's right.
Give your way out of debt. Give your way out of debt.
Yeah.
Yeah.
That's it.
Give your way out of debt.
That's it.
Yeah.
You ain't got nothing I said.
Yeah.
I said give your way out of debt.
Yeah.
Give your way out of debt. Give your way out of debt. You're getting nothing I said.
Yes.
Give your way out of debt.
Yes.
Give your way out of debt. You hear me? Give your way out of debt.
Mm-hmm.
What you give is as important as what you give.
That's right. That's right.
You hear nothing I said. Woman, 1 Kings 17, well, she could have gave anyway. No, she couldn't. No, she couldn't. She couldn't. She couldn't. She had to obey the prophet.
Yeah.
I said, she had to obey the prophet. I didn't say it, the word said it. You know, people get mad about when you talk about that scripture, they get mad. I didn't say it. God said it.
Yes.
He dried up a brook where he had been sustaining the prophet. 1 Kings 17.
Yes.
Something that wasn't even supposed to bless the prophet was blessing the prophet.
Mm-hmm.
Ravens don't bring you no food, they eat it they sell.
Mm-hmm.
They vultures.
Mm-hmm.
But God dried the brook up and sent him to a place called there.
Yeah.
Sent him to Zarephath, place of refining. Sent him.
Thank you.
He brought him from a need to a need.
That's a word.
He brought him from a need to a need.
Amen.
He said, get thee to, he said, he had told him to go to Zarephath, then he said, I need you to move from Zarephath.
Yes, yes. Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Yeah.
But I got a place that I'm sending you.
Yeah.
All right.
And this woman looked like she can't bless you. But I want you to go and deliver the word of the Lord.
Yes.
I want you to go and prophesy. I want you to go and speak life unto this woman.
Yeah.
I'm going to God to use you to be somebody else's answer.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. And then answer your problem while he's answering.
Yeah.
Yes. And done
come on, man.
You ever had a need and God sent you to a need? Now the prophet's waiting for God to fill his brook and God sends him to a problem. Now you would think promotion and God trying to promote the man, but it didn't look like a promotion. He dried a supernatural place up and sent him back to something natural, and then he tells him there's going to be a widow woman there in Zion. There's going to be a widow woman there with a little boy with some sticks. And she's broke. But I'm going to send you there to be a life changer to her.
Yeah.
I'm just hearing this.
Yes.
Sometimes it's the thoughts we're having that keep us where we are.
Yeah.
Amen.
It's the thoughts that we won't let go. Sometimes it takes a prophetic word to come to jar you or loose from that thought you keep having.
Yeah.
It's that thought, it's that cycle of thought that you keep repeating.
See,
it's when the presence of God come, you still in that thought mode.
Yeah.
You still in the wrong mode.
Come on.
Do you know you could be in the place, but you still got to open up to receive?
Yes.
You got to open up to receive.
Yes, you do.
You follow what I'm saying?
We'll miss it.
You know, you can be in the place, but not in the place. You can be in the place, but not hearing in the place.
Yeah.
And faith coming by hearing and hearing the word. You got to hear it. You got to hear it. I mean, you got to hear it till you hear it. You may be driving home and something the prophet say, you got to recycle it in your spirit to you. That's what he said.
Break that band off of you. Break that band with you.
You got to hear it till you hear it.
Hear it till you hear it.
You got to hear it till you defeat that other thought. You got to hear it. Then you got to start responding to what's been said.
That's it.
Even if you don't understand it, you got to start responding like you understand. Mm-hmm. And as you begin to do it, understanding is going to come.
Thank you.
You ain't heard nothing I said.
That.
Now, wait a minute. What kind of preacher, the kind of teacher, like a fit?
Yes.
That woman in 1 Kings 17. You talking about her child?
I don't understand that.
I don't even know you. Yes. You say you're a man of God. I don't know you. I don't know you.
That's happy.
But watch this here. God will really never send you nowhere where you're not known. God will never send you nowhere where you're not known, even though in your flesh you think it's the first time. Come on here. Now watch this here. He tells Elijah in 1 Kings 17, he said, I need you to move from the brook of Sarek and go to Zion. For I have commanded a woman, did he tell him his name, to feed thee there.
Yeah.
There ain't no one enough.
In the natural.
In the natural realm.
Jesus.
But in the spiritual realm, God had already set it up.
Hey!
Yeah.
He's already set it off and set it up in the spirit.
Hey!
You just got to get to the place called there.
Yeah.
There's not a popular place.
Yeah.
There is not to be desired when you're not the one that's supposed to be there.
Yeah.
You get that one.
Yeah.
Amen. Come on, man. Jesus.
Are you following?
Teach. Hey.
You want to get a lot of amens when you delivering people from a place called there.
Yes.
You ain't hearing nothing.
Yes.
Yeah.
Yes.
The cameras won't follow you to the trenches when you're delivering somebody from a place called there.
Yeah.
The month or two, watch this here. Jerusalem went there. You hear nothing I see?
Yeah.
None of the ministers out of Jerusalem was at the Brook of Sarek. Uh-huh. Well, where are all them boys at? Uh-huh. See, it's a certain kind that God trusts with a certain word to go a certain place.
See?
Yeah.
God can't trust everybody to go to a certain place.
Yeah.
He can't trust people to go where I sent you.
Yeah.
Certain parts of town, people, I don't care how known that you are, you ain't known it for that.
Thank you.
You better follow your net. Now, you better get behind that camera and get your head whooped and knocked off.
Yeah.
You can't go where I go.
Yeah.
You're not anointed.
Yeah. See,
the kind of ministry you got to be anointed to go the places you go.
Yes, you do.
Right. You can't go there because I'm a prophet.
Yeah,
right.
Yeah.
Well, you sent.
Yeah.
And that's what you call.
Yeah.
We ain't talking about your calling.
Yeah.
We talking about your sin.
Yeah.
There's a difference in your calling and being sent.
Yeah.
I ain't talking about your calling.
Yeah.
We ain't talking about, what are you sent in my district? What are you sent in my territory?
Yes.
What are you sent in my region? Get your hands up.
Yeah.
Go back.
That's right, prophet. If you ain't that
big. Come on, God's a territorial God. You got to get where God wants you to be.
Yeah.
Come on, Ezekiel.
Hey.
Ezekiel, he didn't say Elijah. Ezekiel, give these bones live.
Yeah.
Bones people. Lord, thou knowest. Then prophesy. So we have not other prophets that passed by the valley of dry bones. Uh-huh. There's many prophets passed, but they couldn't raise they couldn't raise the people. They didn't have the people's word.
Yeah,
that's right.
I just get you. You can't just get to any prophet.
Oh, see,
that don't make that person not a prophet. They didn't have your word. That's why you weren't spoken to.
See,
yeah,
and that's why you didn't have no
word.
Come on. No. Is God sending you?
Yeah.
Have you been handpicked to hear that he or she? hearing nothing I said.
All right.
Hallelujah. It was prophets in Cleveland.
Come on now.
But you had to get out to a place called Bethlehem.
Yeah. That's it. Yeah.
That's it.
You see them on TV. You see them out there. I know some of them up in Cleveland. Got Vernon.
They good.
Vernon. Yeah. I met him this summer. Took a picture with him.
They good too.
Good ministers up there.
Yeah.
But God relocated you.
Yes.
They don't have. Well, he got 20,000 people, but he ain't got your word. He's worldwide. He's worldwide, but he ain't in your word.
Lord, thank you.
Well, I'm going to send you to a no-name prophet. I'm going to send you to one that ain't on TV.
Yeah.
Oh,
my God.
Popular place.
Come on now.
Powerful.
Yes.
Powerful. Amen.
Jesus. Thank
you. Follow what I'm saying?
Amen. Powerful.
You get this word. Well, I just, now you can't give up there.
Yeah.
You got to give here.
Yeah.
Jesus.
Yes.
Make me a cake.
See, say, Jesus.
But I'll send it off. Ain't no reward with that.
Ha!
Wrong Saul.
See?
Didn't say the person was wrong. Wrong Saul.
That's right.
Where he wants you right now.
Mail, your address, but it came to the wrong house. It's a check in there, but she can't cash it.
Yeah.
It's legal check, but her name ain't on it.
That's
so it goes back to the post office.
Yeah.
To this identified.
Yeah.
Jesus. Teach up in this place.
Are you following? Are you hearing what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Are y'all hearing this here?
Yes, sir.
It's in that place that simply where God speaks to you.
Yes.
And he begins to develop your spirit. He moves you from that hurt place. He begins to strengthen you.
Yes.
It ain't how you came in, it's how you're going to leave out.
Ha!
You came in limping and wounded.
Uh-huh. Chief prophet.
Limping. Uh-huh. But as that faith comes,
yeah.
You begin to be regal.
Yeah.
You follow what I'm saying? You begin to take some spiritual adjustments in
the
spirit.
Wait a minute. Wait. You shake this.
Yeah.
The blessing is on my shoulder.
Yeah.
I weep the problems at my feet.
Hallelujah!
Hallelujah!
Yes.
So every time you shake, you're shaking them blessings off your
shoulders.
Yeah. And they're killing the thing at your feet.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. When you can't just shake real good.
There's a song, bro.
Shake it out.
You catch people still looking at you.
Yeah.
You look legal.
Yeah.
My, you look anointed.
Yeah.
Don't I know you sit there? They don't know you. That's out of glory. That's out of glory. I seen you. I don't know where I seen you, but I seen you.
Yeah. Yeah. They sure do. Sure you did. They sure do. In your dream. Sure you did.
Yes.
Yeah.
Man came to do my roof the other day. It was estimate. We got to talking. And I stopped at Mr. Ben and said, I know who you are. He said, I know who you are too.
See?
He said, let me know when the insurance check comes, we'll take care of everything. Mm. He said, some other stuff I'll do up there, it's not a part of it, I'll do.
Yeah.
Hello.
Favor. No contract signed yet.
Favor.
He stopped me. That's my call.
Heresy.
He stopped talking to me.
The favor. Your currency.
Huh? Favor God.
Yeah.
The glory of God. You're going to attract what you need.
Yeah.
See?
Yes.
See, when you see the reason why the enemy wants you to act like a heathen, because when you wrong, they're gonna just lay it at your feet.
Yeah.
A king ain't gotta beg for nothing.
Come on now.
A king ain't gotta beg for nothing.
Yeah, that's right.
It just gonna follow you.
Yeah.
Goodness and mercy shall follow you all the days of our life.
Come on,
goodness and mercy, goodness and mercy, goodness and mercy, goodness and mercy,
yeah.
Goodness and mercy shall follow you all the days of goodness and mercy.
Y'all
gotta get that goodness and mercy, goodness and mercy. The devil, not bark the devil, goodness and mercy, goodness and mercy, goodness and mercy, goodness and mercy. When you get in the car, goodness and mercy get right there and there with you.
Yeah.
Everywhere you go, goodness and mercy is right with you.
Just follow.
Let's go.
Yeah.
Let's go.
Yeah.
Yes. Let's go.
You ain't got nothing I'm saying.
Yes,
I'm telling you, you're not alone. You're not alone. Do you follow what I'm saying?
Yeah.
You're not alone. When you're looking at the contract,
you're
goodness and mercy is looking at every line, even that you don't see.
Mm-hmm.
That you don't see.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
You hear what I'm saying?
Yes.
Raise that right there. All the days of your life.
Yeah.
Goodness and mercy will interrupt a season.
Yes, it will.
That's unfavorable and make it favorable.
Hey.
Goodness and mercy. Yeah. Goodness and mercy will come in and change the decision. Goodness and mercy. I hear the word accelerate. A little bit more. God said acceleration. He said acceleration. I'm accelerating the time. I'm speeding up the time. I'm redeeming the time. I'm putting time on your side. Time that was lost, I'm redeeming it.
Thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Lord. Can you follow me?
Yes, sir. Thank you, Jesus.
Can I submit to you? There's some things get ready to happen. I'm going to blow your mind.
Yes, I believe it, probably.
If you're sitting in this room, there's some things getting ready to go down. I'm not talking about far off either.
Yes, yes.
Hallelujah. You got to check back in with God and say, God, is this you?
Yes.
Is this you?
Yes.
You're going to wake up with some stuff that ain't going to be in your body no more.
Yes.
You got to hear what I'm saying.
Glory.
If you're in this room, you better pray to live. But death ain't nowhere near you. If you're in this room, I don't care how you feel. I don't care what report. I don't care about none of that. If you up in here, you should live and not die. And die, live, regal for the Lord in every area of your life, spiritually, physically, mentally, financially, socially.
Yes.
Favor of the Lord God.
Regal.
Favor of the Lord God.
Thank you, Lord.
To you, King and priest.
Yeah.
King and priests. Kings and priests. Wait a minute. Kings and priests.
Kings and priests.
Wait a minute. Let's come to work. The priest and the king, right quick.
Yeah.
The priest. Come on. The priest deals with the spiritual.
Come on here.
The king deals with the earth.
Come on now.
You preach me. Get priestly information.
Yes.
And then when you get that priestly information, you slip into your kingship.
Hey!
And you begin the law of the earth.
Yes.
From a priestly conscience.
Hey, the high priest.
Are you following what I'm saying? Are you following what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Yes, God.
Now watch this here. Now watch. Understand me. Now your position is high as a priest in the Levites was.
Yes, yeah.
Are you following what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm.
We priests, them men weren't saved. Them unsaved people back then.
Yeah.
In the Old Testament. You got the Holy Ghost now.
Come on now.
You hear what I'm saying? You working with something. You're the deal.
Yeah.
Uh-huh.
Thank you, Lord.
Mm-hmm. Abraham said they long to see this day.
Yeah.
Are y'all hearing this? Are you hearing me, Margo?
Yes.
Are y'all hearing this? Are y'all hearing this?
Yeah.
Are you hearing me? Are you hearing me, son? I wish I could have got a hold of this word when I was your age.
Me too,
brother. It's true.
You need
to push it though anymore. You can just walk in.
Yeah.
Ooh, you can walk into this shit. Mm-hmm. You got access. Come on, you ain't got to beg for nothing. He said, it's my good pleasure to give you the kingdom.
Come on now.
To give you the kingdom. Are you in it?
Yes.
To give you the kingdom.
Yes.
You lack nothing.
Lord.
I submit to you, you get ready to live the best days of your life.
Yes.
You get ready to live the best days of your life.
Yes.
Are you following what I'm saying? I don't care how young you are, how old you are, you get ready to live the best days of. If you got breath in your body, you better wrap your thinking around what this prophet said. You shall live and not die, and your barrel shall not drop, but it shall overflow to the overflowing, saith the Lord.
Amen. Amen.
Ain't no lack. God said, tell her, I'm going to honor their ideas. I'm going to honor their thoughts. I'm going to honor their dreams. Are you hearing me, little prophet? Are you hearing me, young man? Are you hearing me, Justin? Time to take action.
Take action,
man. I ain't got no money. You don't need no money. You need faith.
You are money.
You need faith. What you need is faith. For all you need is faith that pleases God. Even don't want your money, he wants your faith. If he gets your money, he got everything about you. He can get your identity if he gets your faith. You follow what I'm saying?
Yeah.
We're getting ready to experience the glory of God like never before.
Yes, I believe it's her.
The manifestation of God's goodness.
Yes.
I'm talking about the manifestation of God's goodness.
Yes.
They gonna wonder, how in the world did you pull it off? How did you get through that one?
My Lord.
How in the world is you, what, something about her?
Yes.
She spoke the lost her mind.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
I did, but I didn't lose God's mind. I lost a mind that wasn't working.
Yes. Yeah.
I got a different take on life.
Hallelujah.
Come on now.
See.
I lost the mind that caught me, that made me broke.
Yes.
The mind that keep me sick. The mind that keep me. I lost that mind.
Come on now.
And I started letting this mind be in me. That was all. So. In Christ Jesus.
Come on,
yeah.
Now.
Come on. And Jesus thought it not robbery to be equal with God.
Come on, see,
man. Equal. He said equal. He said he thought it not robbery to be equal. It didn't take nothing from God for him to think he was like God.
See, because
you are. You made from him. You his seed. I don't want to take his glory. You can't take the glory when you're the glory. You are the glory. And the story of the book. Swallow, I come in the volume of the book of you, for it is written of me. I come in the volume of the book. Great is he that was in you. Christ in you, the hope of glory.
Yes, yes, yes. You better
know this. The hope of glory. You're going to be the hope of glory. You think God worried about you stealing something from him? You are his agent. You are his legs. You are his eyes, his arms. You his vehicle. I'll be to walk you up on some stuff.
See?
Before you know, you go, I know what all this is.
Yeah.
God, what do I say? I'll tell you what to
That's
say.
That's it.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Lord, you feel it. Amen.
God will feel your mouth.
Amen.
Yes, it will.
Come on, man. You got to get intimidated. Are y'all hearing this here?
Yes.
Are y'all hearing this here?
Woo!
I feel the noise. I feel the anointing of God.
Amen.
You hear that, mother? You hear that, Timmy? Some say the best days of my life.
The best days of my life.
Amen.
Because I choose to be in the place of God.
Yes.
God's a detailed God.
Yes, Lord. Thank you.
Tell you how to look, how not to look. Tell you when to speak. Tell you what time to arrive. Tell you not to go.
Yeah.
Tell you how much to pay for, what don't pay for.
Yeah.
Tell you to get involved, don't get involved.
Yeah.
Say something, don't say nothing. Mm-hmm.
Yes, Jesus.
Mm-hmm.
Help us, God.
Yes.
Are we hearing this here?
Yes, yes, sir.
Go ahead.
And me and Tim were real, boy. That Tim was born with me. Was ever seen. Me and Tim was ever seen. I got the intercessor. But let me tell you something, when he was dropping that, when we get ready to defeat your Goliath, the anointing of the temple preacher ain't gonna get it. He has to get a giant killer. Yeah. Come on,
because
they was already on the field,
yeah.
And they was scared of the giant,
yeah.
And they was the warriors, they was the military,
so to speak,
supposed to be in the deal.
Yeah.
But listen here, and they was under the king, saw them, and they was sitting there scared because Goliath stood up, with that wolf crack in his mouth, talking noise,
yeah.
They was scared. He was whooping and they was getting scared. So God went and got an anointing, went back in the desert.
Yeah.
We got a desert anointing.
What? Come on.
We got a good anointing. So wait a minute, let me go get me a fighter. Somebody I done raised up to fight.
Yeah.
Somebody I done raised up to whoop. Come on, girl. Beast.
Yeah.
No, no, no. Whoop beast in the desert. Let me go get me a beast killer. Give me a bear slayer.
Yeah.
Come on, that's the anointing that's ready. And then he walked him on there, Lord have mercy, with a little bit to say. My friend said, Baboon. He said, oh, wait a minute, what? You uncircumcised Philistine, he said, I'm going to take your head out. Yeah. He didn't even ask for nothing. Then they tried to put their little anointing on him. He said, oh, I can't work with that. He tried, I can't use that. You know why? Because it ain't been tried.
Yeah.
I got to use what's been tried.
Yeah. Yeah. Oh,
that's it. I've been whooping birds.
Yeah.
I've been over here slaying birds.
Yeah.
Come on, girl. Whooping Tiger. Snakes.
Yeah.
Oh, come on, girl. He said, I can't use that. I don't disrespect. No disrespect.
Yeah.
I can't use
religion.
He can't use that tradition. You got to keep this anointing.
Yeah.
Come on, girl. And then he stood up and he just went and talked to him. Now, how are you going to whoop a giant? And he said he just had 5 smooth stones, just had him a little slingshot of faith. Come on here.
Yeah.
He took that faith, and every word came out of his mouth.
Yes,
and he slung that
word,
and that word went into that giant's head and dismantled all his authority.
Yeah.
David's moment, because definitely it promoted him. Yeah. See, so what you learning back here in the desert, in the wilderness, don't curse your wilderness. Learn from it.
Yeah.
Come on here.
Oh,
grow from it. Come on here. Be strengthened in it. Hello. You ain't got time to murmur, complain about it. Know that God is perfecting you in it. Because when you get up to the line, when God get ready to slay your enemy, because I want to submit to you, are you at your place right now where you're going to slay your giant so you can come into your promotion?
Yeah.
But see, every time God get ready to promote you, it's already a giant. You got to kill it. And you can't use that little old temple priest anointing.
Yeah.
You got to come out of there with your barrel whooping.
Yeah.
Come on, girl. Lying, defeat. Come on, girl.
Yeah.
Stuff, all that stuff that made you. Come on, girl. Stuff you done got up and whooped in the desert.
Yes.
You
got to
bring on her and don't be ashamed.
Yeah.
Amen.
Come on here and whoop it in Jesus' name.
Yeah.
Hello, somebody. Yeah. And God's getting ready to promote you. So this ain't the time to get nervous. Don't get scared. That's why I say, don't be weary, do it well.
Yeah.
Don't get weary. Don't get weary in this season. Because, you know, you right at the transition, right before your promotion, the enemy's going to rise up to try to manipulate you.
Yeah.
Come on here and depress you.
Yeah.
But you got to shake it. The prophet said, well, shake it. Glory to God. And stand up and slay that giant and cross over on the other side.
Yeah.
Amen. Because some of you sitting here today, this is your season to cross over. You're coming up out of lack.
Yeah.
Come on here. God will put an anointing upon you for the millions.
Amen.
Receive that.
Man.
I said, God have to anoint you for the meal.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Yes.
No, we have to anoint you for the big money.
Yes.
Glory to God.
Yes.
Because that's a whole nother
ring
around right there.
Yes.
When you come in there. Because see, if you ain't got this man, you will lose your mind.
Yes.
When you get with the big money. Because over there, don't know rules work. They just do all kind of stuff.
Yeah.
And see, you have to have a mind. The mind of God to be focused, that you don't slip into darkness.
Yeah.
Come on, you got to know, come in there that you really knowing that you are the one that's going to be, you know, got the goods.
Yes.
And you got to be the steward over the goods.
Yeah.
And you got to know where the goods go.
Come on.
Because you coming to take the region over.
Yeah.
You coming to snatch it out of the hand of the
baby. Yes.
This phone waiting on you.
Yes.
Quit playing. People ain't coming to church because it's raining. You better get your butt up because folks
you
waiting
on you. You got to talk
to me. That phone waiting on you.
Yeah.
I said, how you going to see when people waiting on you?
Yeah.
Look, it's a region. It's a generation waiting on you.
Yeah.
You're going to be sleeping. Tell me you tired and it's raining and I don't feel. You better get up.
Yeah.
You better guard up.
Yeah.
Come on here. Talking about you want your sons and daughters. You better guard up.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Come on here. So you can get them this baton and they can rule.
Yeah.
And rule well.
Yeah.
Glory to God. How many know that God got it all worked out for us?
Yeah.
Amen.
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 Amen. I got that wrong way. Sit in my seat. Don't understand.
The force to be reckoned with.
Yeah.
Baboon.
Mother, you did that.
God's awesome, isn't he?
Yes, he is.
He's awesome, isn't he?
Jesus.
That's where he came.
Mm-hmm.
things going down. I'm telling you, some things going down.
Yes, and he promised. He used to always say, he said, that's my Caleb, that's my Josh.
Yes.
Get us to my, you met Caleb, let's go. I said, let's go.
Ooh, man.
God is awesome. God is awesome. Let's go to, give me a few more time. Give me about 5 more minutes.
Okay.
I seen some land the other day.
This land we couldn't take.
Yeah.
And, so if you're off of, it's, oh, that's the what you're talking about? Now, actually, someone, I actually talked to the people that own that is in California. I actually talked to a lady, her husband is deceased. But anyway, the land is, it sits, it's a shopping center area.
Uh-huh.
And in it's off of Loop 12 over in that area.
Yeah, YouTube.
Oh, yeah, I'm on YouTube.
Yeah. Don't even joke.
Right there. We just leave that alone.
Yeah.
But when we go out, we take it. I forgot.
Let's go get it.
Amen. We can take it.
Yeah.
We'll
yes, we got it.
I woke up Friday.
Can't nobody else
ask. And
nobody.
That's I went there the week I told you I went there. And you said, well, I know so. But anyway, who owns it actually is a woman that's out of state in California.
California.
Where we and so right. And so and so and so there was a man that was doing the taking care of the parking lot and stuff. And so I'm looking at the building, you know, and I didn't call her on the phone. And so he said, you finna buy that building? And he said, you gonna rent that building? I said, no, I'm gonna buy the whole. I'm interested in buying the whole thing.
That's right.
He said, you want to see it? I got the keys. This for the yard man. He said, I got the keys. I said, you got the keys. He said, yeah. He said, for the last 5 years, I'm the guy. He said, now the lady that hired me, I know who you just called. I've never seen her, but she sends me a check every month for taking care of the facility. She says, her husband, he gave me the scoop. He said, her husband passed, and she don't want the property. She said, many people have came here, and I begin to tell them some things I want to do. He said, but you know, I feel good about you. Something about you is different. He said, we have a lot of hustlers come through trying to beat her out and all this kind of stuff.
Yeah.
Never long story short. Anyway, long story short. But anyway, he let me in. I walked around. It's one of them Nehemiah projects.
Yeah.
You follow what I'm saying?
Yeah.
You got to have a mind to work.
Yeah.
You follow what I'm saying? Yeah. And but when I seen it, I didn't see the ruins.
Mm-mm.
I'm like Nehemiah.
Yeah.
I seen the gates all up.
Yeah.
You ain't hear nothing I seen. And then as I'm looking at that property, I don't know if y'all remember Ella Darcy back in the day. We saw the big building there on. He said, now the city got that now. He said, the city wants to get rid of that. The city got custom in that
one.
I said, we might as well get that too.
Yeah, get that.
I'm in process of talking, and some things gonna go down.
Yeah,
yes, it is.
Yeah.
It's already.
You gonna need some faith, people.
Yeah.
Yes. Amen.
Yeah.
Get in the trenches.
Yes.
Yes.
You tell me you can lay the whole thing out there.
Yeah.
Right.
Yeah.
Build that
thing
and
pray
for
us. I'll tell y'all more about it off the air. I know I'm talking in bits and pieces, and so.
Yeah.
But anyway, I have stood on. I've been in it, and. And guess what? We can take that.
Yeah.